One again major discussion topic about direct and indirect speech. So there is some confusion about direct and indirect speech. So Rahul, I'll explain about the direct and indirect speech. Generally, the confusions which are there in the minds of students, try to hurry up and discuss this topic. So here, different types of sentences can be changed from direct to indirect speech. And children generally get confused when changing the questions in direct speech into indirect speech. So there is a confusion from direct to indirect speech. So we'll take care of this topic right now. Now let me explain to you, there are two types of questions. One is the first group is the W family questions, that is when, where, what, etc. And the second type of question is the second group is the yes or no question. Yes or no question. So these are the two types of questions asked in a direct sentence. Now in this W family questions, the connector used is the question word itself. The connector used is the question word itself. And for the yes or no question, the connector if or whether are used. So I think it is clear for both. For the W family, the connector used is the question word itself. So we'll explain this further with the example. And for the second group of questions, that is the yes or no questions, the connector if or whether are required, are used. So we'll take care about this with an example. Now let me explain it to you with the help of one example. Suppose this is a direct sentence. He said to me, comma, inverted commas begin, where do you live? Where do you live? Is it interrogative sentence? So when you change it to indirect, this is the direct question. When you change to indirect question, he asked me where I lived. So now when you connect this to the example, where do you live is a W family question because it starts with W. So we'll apply this system. Connector used is the, this is the connector. This is the connector here where that is the question word itself. So this is the question and this is the question word itself. So when we change it to indirect, we will say that he asked me where I lived. We can take one more example to make it more clear. Suppose this is direct sentence. Mother said to her, comma, inverted commas, have you done the work? Have you done the work? Again, integrative sentence. So we'll change it to the indirect speech. Mother asked her if, because this question is not a W family, this sentence is not a W family question. So mother asked her if or whether she had done the work. She had done the work. Now you can use both if and whether for the indirect speech, because here this is the second group of question or a second group of interrogative sentence, because here we are starting with have you done the work. So I think you can use any one of them, if and whether. So I think this is clear to you.